Monsieur de Mirabeau's home is built on a hill in the area. I have no intention of harming you. The Royal Automats are my only enemies.
Par tous les saints! You were sent by heaven above!
Have you watched these machines?
Yes! I had a front row seat! A swarm of ferocious beasts who cleared the way for a creature I have a nightmare! It was the Grim Reaper, madame. Death! Itself. Nothing and no one was spared. I was spellbound and horrified by its dance of death. If by misfortune you find yourself in its presence, do not let it leap in your direction. Those who suffered its lightning attack did not survive. None of them, without exception. Come now, if you claim to want to destroy these automats, it's time to get going. You must stop them from advancing.
Thank you. Chin up, old man. Bite down on this strip of leather. I'm going to take a closer look at your wound. Oh, it's more serious than I thought. Look at me. You have to hang in there, all right? You mustn't fall asleep.
Vincent. No. I'm losing him.
Is there any way I can help you?
Seigneur, an automat.
What can I expect from you, other than the cruel fate that your fellow monsters reserve for patriots?
You have nothing to fear from me, monsieur.
Honestly, I don't have much of a choice. I have to take you at your word and ask for your help. I have with me a fighter who has lost his leg. He's already lost a lot of blood. If I don't operate within the hour, I doubt he will survive. Unfortunately, I do not have any surgical tools with me. Would you be so kind as to find me something I can use to save this brave man? I can't do anything until I have the right equipment. I can't do anything until I have the right equipment.
So, I put it to you that the fact that the society is in need of
Monsieur de Mirabeau.
The demon can speak? Speak then! Has my time come?
I do not know.
My life is in your hands. It's not worth much. Do what you will with it.
I seek Monsieur de Vaucanson. He holds the secret to the tireless automats.
And you think you'll find him here, in my quarters? Tell me, who is your master? Aren't you one of Cagliostro's creatures?
I serve only the Queen.
Ah, the Queen. Well then, that's something else altogether.
I found this message in Monsieur de Vaucanson's carriage.
He didn't receive it. That is most worrying. Eugène and I are old friends. I was hoping he would be able to tell me what the deuce is going on. Of course, I doubt he had a hand in this odious display of force, but he spent years in service to the king and his projects. Projects whose macabre ends we're only now discovering.
Where could Monsieur de Vaucanson have gone?
How should I know? The situation is dire out there. Everyone is taking shelter wherever they can. Let me think. I know that he and Monsieur Bailly, the astronomer, are close. Perhaps Monsieur Bailly knows more?
Where can he be found?
He must have taken refuge in his observatory at the Louvre. Otherwise, I doubt he is still alive. He and his associate Lavoisier, the astronomer and the chemist, they were once the pride of the court, but have fallen out of favor. Too close to the common people, it would seem. It's as if only Vaucanson managed to stay in the king's good graces. Sic transit gloria mundi.
Who is this Cagliostro?
You feign ignorance.
I do not know.
Then you should know that Cagliostro is the king's right-hand man. He claims to be a magician, and he is a self-styled count.
A charlatan who is more powerful than a minister.
Precisely. I've heard the most troubling rumors about him. He's supposedly the one who enabled the king to breathe life into these killing machines that no key need wind. I admit it sounds highly improbable, and I wouldn't believe a word of it if I didn't have proof standing right before my eyes. Now that I think about it, as you can see, my servants have all abandoned me, and I will soon follow their lead. Those poor people hoped to escape the city while there was still time. A dire vrai, I fear I shall never see them alive again. Before she left, the housekeeper gave me this key. It opens the gate that leads to the Louvre, if you are foolhardy enough to attempt it.
I found a note written by Eugène de Vaucanson. He mentions the death of the Dauphin at Meudon. What happened that night?
How should I know? The child passed away at Meudon. I was in Versailles.
Besides the king and Monsieur de Vaucanson, who else witnessed these events?
Well, if they followed protocol, Monsieur Le Monnier, the first physician to the king, he must have performed the autopsy on the child.
Where can I find him?
He lives in Versailles, near the chateau, but he has a practice here in Paris, on Rue Saint-Thomas d'Enfer, in the Quartier Saint-André-des-Arts.
Eugène de Vaucanson told you nothing?
The only thing he was willing to tell me was that something terrible had happened, and that the circumstances leading to the Dauphin's death were not exactly as described. One thing for certain is that he was extremely upset about what happened, so much so that he refused to spend a single day more in the king's service. But he has apparently changed his mind.
saw it just today, as clearly as I can see you now.
That's impossible. That makes no sense.
Do you think I've gone mad?
No, of course not. But how can Monsieur Balsamo make these machines obey him?
Monsieur Balsamo, you say?
De Jesu! An automat right on our doorstep!
Malheur! We are lost!
Do not fear. I am not like the other machines.
A la bonne heure. This one speaks and thinks, at least.
We'd better stay on our guard.
So you saw this Monsieur Balsamo giving orders to the machines?
Bien sûr. I saw him walk through the gate to his workshop, just a few paces from here, accompanied by a dozen automats. They made no move to attack him. Oh no, bien au contraire, they were acting like his bodyguards.
What does Monsieur Balsamo do?
Who knows? He's a very discreet man.
Discreet? You'd have to be deaf to find him discreet. What about the racket keeps us up every night? The clatter of scrap metal, the creaking of pulleys, rumblings of all kinds. We suffer through it all. Not to mention the god-awful screams that emanate from that sinister workshop from time to time.
A most unusual fanfare, c'est vrai. However, there's no way of knowing what he's doing there. And that's why we cannot tell you anything more.
Madame, would you be so kind as to leave now? We don't want to draw attention to ourselves.
Thank you. No one, not even the king, can stop the representatives of the people from continuing their work. Wherever its members are gathered, the Assemblée Nationale lives. That is why we swear never to part, and to gather wherever circumstances require it, until a constitution is established for the kingdom.
Come here, mon ami. I salute you.
Monsieur, we have just burned our bridges. Nothing and no one can prevent justice from triumphing in this kingdom.
Let us not claim victory too soon, Maximilien. And don't forget what we agreed on, if things were to take a turn for the worse.
His lordship, the king's brother, has answered my message. He has agreed to see me, despite the circumstances.
The Comte de Provence? Do you trust him?
If he still has any influence over the king, we must try. I shall leave immediately for the Luxembourg Palace.
Be careful, Antoine. I implore you. The whole Cartier is ablaze.
Monsieur, this is the last time we shall meet. From now on, we shall do without your help. Eh bien, are you waiting for an invitation to leave?
Your Majesty, dare we ask what brought this disgrace upon us?
The Count's work has given me complete satisfaction. Your essences and optics are no longer of any use to us.
Rejoice, learned scholars. You may now dedicate yourselves to the cause of the Vanupier.
Just a moment. Are we being rebuked for our actions at the Estates General? But Your Majesty, you are the one who convened this assembly.
Leave here at once, monsieur, before you say anything you might regret.
They're here. A horde of assassins. Death itself encased in an iron shell. Flee! Gentlemen, flee! While there is still time!
There. You are no longer in danger.
Lydia? Are you the one who has released me from this nightmare? But how? Did your master send you?
My name is not Lydia, monsieur. I'm called Aegis, and I serve only the Queen.
Oh. A pauvre enfant. Lydia. Aegis. And yet I fear that you are neither.
It is of no importance, monsieur. I have a mission to accomplish. Where is Monsieur de Vaucanson hiding?
He is hiding, as you say, in a cell in the Bastille prison. Shackled hand and foot. That is how our good king has decided to reward his most faithful servant. As for you, my child, I can't be sure, but I think there is a truth you must uncover. Find your way to Monsieur de Vaucanson's home. It is in the Faubourg Saint-Germain, east of the Invalides. Here is the key to the gate. When we meet again, we will have the answers we seek.
Your colleague, Monsieur Lavoisier, do you know where he is?
He went to the Palais de Luxembourg, despite the danger.
Why?
He hoped to convince the Comte de Provence to speak to his brother, the King, and have Eugène de Vaucanson released from prison. But he hasn't been seen since, nor given any sign of life.
What did you see and hear before you regained consciousness?
I don't know how to describe it. A vrai dire, I was in a sinister and icy place. Et puis, it's all a blur. A poisonous feeling of destructive power. Somewhere between a dream and reality. Orders whispered in my ear. Poor, terrified people falling at my hand. I don't know if I was given some powerful drug, or if my mind was truly lost in the ether. If this is the case, the phenomenon should be studied. But can it be reproduced?
What did you see and hear before you regained consciousness?
I don't know how to describe it. A vrai dire, I was in a sinister... it's all a blur of poisonous orders whispered. I don't know if this is the case.
Your colleague, Monsieur Lavoisier...
He went to the pal...
Why?
He hoped to come and have... but he hasn't... For now, I will attempt to reach the safe haven where those who oppose the king swore to gather, in hopes that any of them escaped the massacre.